That is Daime Adesina with a track called Dance and Fly, Danse y Voyar. Closing out the show tonight. It's all I've got time for. Thank you for joining me, everyone. I'm Jamie Cullum, and this has been a Folded Wing production for BBC Radio 2 on the BBC Sounds app, on your smart speaker, and on 88 to 91 FM.
BBC News at 10 o'clock. This is Catherine Cracknell. Mikhail Gorbachev, the last leader of the Soviet Union, has died. He was 91. He was in office from 1985 to 1991, and his reforms set in train events which led to the collapse of Soviet communism and helped to end the Cold War. Our Russia editor, Steve Rosenberg, looks back at his life.
Mikhail Gorbachev had set out to modernise, to open up the Soviet Union. By the time he left office, the country didn't exist. He'll be remembered by many in Russia as the leader who lost an empire. And yet Gorbachev was instrumental in ending the Cold War. He worked with the American president, Ronald Reagan, to slash nuclear arsenals. His reforms at home inspired millions across Central and Eastern Europe, where communist regimes tumbled. But much of what Gorbachev changed didn't last. In today's Russia, the democratic freedoms he championed are being eroded, and East-West confrontation is back.
The UN has warned Pakistan is facing a monsoon on steroids after floods submerged one third of the country. More than 1,100 people have been killed since June. Roads, homes and bridges have been washed away. The British High Commissioner to Pakistan, Christian Turner, says there's a mountain to climb ahead.
We're talking 33 million people affected. That's the size of a small country. 1 million homes destroyed, 500,000 people in camps. And then the livelihoods that will flow after this urgent relief, with 2 million acres of farmland flooded. That means the crop won't come in, maybe 750,000 livestock killed, and that's before we get to the road infrastructure, the bridges that have been washed away. The task ahead of us really is enormous.
The EU says it's giving more than 5 million anti-radiation tablets to Ukraine as fears grow of an accident at the Zaporizhia nuclear plant. The Russian-occupied site has recently come under fire, with both sides blaming each other. So far, only people living within 30 miles of the plant are being offered the tablets. An inquest into the death of 9-year-old Olivia Pratt Corbell has heard how a police officer tried to save her life after she was shot in Liverpool a week ago. The coroner, Andre Ribello, said the officer pressed their hand on her wound as they carried her to hospital. Tennis, and Cameron Norrie and Dan Evans are through to the second round of the men's singles at the US Open in New York. Earlier, Norrie, the British number one and seventh seed in the tournament, won two sets 6-love against Benoit Paire of France. Afterwards, he had some sympathy for his opponent.
I played an insane first set. Second set, he got to tiebreak. He served for the second set, and then he played a shocking tiebreak. I think it's part of his career and the way he plays. He's very flashy. He has really good weeks and then weeks that he doesn't show up.
And tonight's weather, any showers in the southeast will ease and there'll be clear spells for most. And that's the BBC News at 3 minutes past 10.
Thank you, Catherine, and thanks to Jamie Cullum.
It's Trevor Nelson's Magnificent Seven.
In fact, it's Tuesday night's Magnificent Seven. Welcome to the Rhythm Nation here on BBC Radio 2. I've got seven tunes lined up for you. I hope you're feeling well. I hope you've had a decent day. If you want a shout out, get involved. Text me, WhatsApp me. You can email me too. I'd love to hear from you.
The Magnificent Seven on BBC Radio 2.
There's a road. A fist-knit blood, and the beautiful flies with the dove.